The current map of Palestine is often described as resembling Swiss cheese. Over the past century, it has been carved up, walled up, and filled with hundreds of illegal Israeli settlements and military checkpoints. Now, in the latest round of Israel's ongoing occupation and policy of land grabs, this map could become even more disjointed. On July 1, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu is expected to announce Israel's annexation of the Jordan Valley and Northern Dead Sea. Annexation is a term used when a regime unilaterally incorporates another territory within its borders. Annexing the Jordan Valley would mean that Israel would officially consider it part of its regime. International law is very clear. Annexation and territorial conquest are forbidden by the Charter of the United Nations. Yet Israel continues to occupy Palestine and now plans on looting more Palestinian land and resources. Opponents of annexation, even inside the illegal Israeli settlements, believe that if Israel moves ahead with plans to annex parts of the occupied West Bank and Jordan Valley, they will have no choice but to declare their adopted homeland occupation as a modern-day version of apartheid-era South Africa. There will be Israeli overlords in an occupied area, and the people over whom they will be ruling will not have basic rights. Yeah, I know, as if Palestinians were enjoying all the sorts of basic rights before this new annexation plan, as if this has not been the case since 1948. Despite the existence of the Palestinian Authority, Israel has ultimate de facto control over the West Bank. It controls entry and exit, water and all other resources, and overall security. Even under useless interim peace accords, Israel also maintains full control over 60% of the West Bank, where all illegal settlements are located and tens of thousands of Palestinians live but have no voice. It's appalling to Palestinians that only now critics of annexation view Israel as an apartheid regime, when several years back the Israeli parliament passed its national state law, which declared the country to be the national home of the Jewish people, while downgrading the status of all Palestinians, whether Muslims, Christians, or secular. Welcome to the Mideast Stream. I'm Marwa Osman.